Alright, from here I'm gonna take a little detour. I'm gonna go back to Central Yard. So we're gonna go find Eileen the Crow. I skipped this the first time around. I kind of bulldozed my way through the first time. I tried to go a few times as I, or tried to look up as little as possible as far as walkthroughs and whatnot. I missed a lot, I'm sure. Come on over. Somehow they're all the same, exactly the same facial expressions and clothes and everything. I mean, there's no individuality at all. They even got the same freaking suspenders on. I probably didn't need to go over here, but I do need to talk to this old woman, though. I know, come get me. Come on. There you go. No. Ah. The dog doesn't even kill me. It's like the troll failed. You're a complete failure. Fight me with your kitchen table, huh? Yeah, there's another stupid trolls up here. He's, got these guys pretty big. I thought trolls were little guys.
Shouldn't go after that guy with the giant sword. Maybe I shouldn't try and fight him with my nightstand.
Oh, and I went the wrong way for that, but did I? Yes, I did. Maybe not. Man, I'll kill these guys anyway. And walk right into their attacks. As you can see, you know, this game probably isn't that hard. I just suck. I'm just not that good. Oh, here we go. That's why I'm such a high level. I got so pissed. Jesus, that would have been nice. I got such a high level. I mean, I was very, very bad at this game. Still am. That's why I compensated. Probably overly compensated for it. I mean, this is a, Yeah, this is gonna be where that stupid thing, stupid, that was intelligent. I probably should. probably not gonna give me enough to worry about it. And some sort of a OCD issue on the podcaster. I'm not even trying to get through these guys. I'm just trying to get up here, say, to talk to them. I need to send one of those women over to the church there. And that little guy will give me some stuff. I don't know what he's gonna give me, but.
Wretched outsider.
Oh, fuck you.
Trying to fool the heavens.
Oh, asshole.
I think he's gonna say something to me, is he? Nope. Come get this old fat boy. Oh, geez, yes, he did.
Hello, Mr. Hunter. Still come? But maybe Mom and Dad are waiting for me to come and find what you think, Mr. Hunter. Yes, okay. Thank you, Mr. Hunter. I love you almost as much as Mom and Dad. And Granddad.
Well, they're dead and, well...
Thank you. I love you almost...
And I'm sure the other one, he will be here at some point. It's a stupid kid. Oh, this is over here. I didn't even realize that the entire time that I played this game. I never realized that. I usually play a lot of RPGs, but I'm like, God damn it, stop shooting me in the face, RPGs like that, like, Final Fantasy and whatnot, but, I love, come on, yes. But I normally, play these RPGs, but I loved the game. Dante's Inferno on the PS3, they did a hell of a job. I mean, I did have like a Bastard Stripper at the book, the Divine Comedy, Dante Alighieri, and we played the song and band, yada yada, and so I was interested in it already, but man, that game was very well done, and if this was recommended, if you like Dante's, and I can almost see why, but. It doesn't in actuality have all that much in common. It really doesn't have all that much in common with it. It's more the they try to say that the combat system had a similarity, and I see what they mean. Like there's in that game you end up fighting hordes of demons in hell, and I mean there's literal hordes, they'll come by the dozens and come at you, but the combat system in that game is a lot smoother. It's a lot. It's not forgiving by any means. Like this game, neither is Bloodborne, but yeah. Come at me with your musket. I don't know. difference is these guys, like these guys, they take off a lot. They can shoot off. And just because it's a new game plus, I know, and they're more powerful. So am I. So is my armor. And it's, the balance is pretty much set as far as that goes. But with Dante's, it was such a. The environment was so great. They managed to get a lot out of the setting in that game. That's one of the things I really enjoyed. And it is with this one, too. But I'm actually just damn close. I get so pissed off when you get, you know, you go a ways. Maybe you find a freaking, you know, one of these freaking lanterns around, and all of a sudden, you know, now you're screwed. You die, and then you gotta go back, you know, 15, 20 minutes, and then it just starts to feel like work. Not about that. I'm gonna find this, one of these assholes. There are very few things you'll actually find in this game behind the scenes, and it's like probably the second one I think I found. I forget what, there was a guy looking at like, or a website, and they said, break everything you see, you'll never know what you're gonna find. It's like, yeah, nothing. I'm not gonna find anything. Asshole. It's probably why I don't write guidebooks. They start coming up with asinine bullshit like that. Alright, where are we? I'm down here. Boy. I am not one of these idiots. What the hell these things are? What the hell are they trying to hit me with? That's so cool. Is it an old, like, saw? Like, from the Three Stooges? I love how you could be like, he'd be like 2 feet from getting ready to stab him in the face with this giant sword, or you know, shoot him with your giant cannon, and they're still like, gotta reload, I shouldn't move, I should just reload. It's a ghost. Standing inside a ghost. Well, that was really interesting too, I like the way they put like, you bastard. Where the hell is he? Oh, I see. God damn it, then I let him do it again. Asshole, level 200. That's how bad I suck. Son of a bitch. This is what I'm talking about. Now I'm gonna have to go all the way back there and get all those stupid blood echoes. I'm obviously not gonna make you guys sit through there. That'd be asinine, and I wouldn't blame you guys for unsubscribing if I did. So I think I'm just gonna end this one here. It's a little short. Probably edit it out even shorter, but next time hopefully I'll be getting to Eileen the Crow, which I've skipped before. Yeah. Try to get to Eileen. Try and get through a few more interesting parts, things that I've stumbled on. Some random goofiness, and we'll see you next time. If you like it, subscribe, comment, anything. Hit him with a high. Thanks. Alright, here I am back here. This is another in our Bloodborne New Game Plus series. This is my first game, New Game Plus. Headed to the casino. Yeah, there's an area. This is where the game really starts to branch out. There's a few different ways of doing this. I'm going to show you what I think is the better way. I mean, to tell you the truth, I mean, you can usually go through. I mean, you can really go through it any way you want. There's a few different ways. Some easier than others. We're almost to the point where you could, if I had purchased the old hunters, where you could get that DLC. Let him hit. I'm like,
stand the whole thing. So far, I think so. My message, which is very asinine and kind of mean as far as the story goes. Oh, hey, here he is, Alfred. So I shouldn't stab him. Well, later on.
You're a beast hunter, aren't you? I knew it. That's precisely how I started out. Oh, beg pardon. You may call me Alfred. Protege of Master Ligarius, hunter of vile bloods. So, what say you? Our prey might differ, but we are hunters, the both of us. Why not cooperate and discuss the things we've learned? Oh, very good. Very good indeed.
Because nobody can lie.
Take this to celebrate our acquaintance.
Oh, good. Give me some paper. Thank you. Not money or, you know, help or, you know, weapon, something. You know, here, have this barely useful item.
Beast hunting is a sacred practice. May the good blood guide your way.
Good blood. Give me some good blood.
There must be oodles for us to share. Go on. Just tell me what piques your interest. As you know, the healing church is the fountainhead of blood healing. Well, I'm a simple hunter, quite unfamiliar with the ins and outs of the institution.
Then why are you telling me?
I heard that the holy medium of blood healing is venerated in the main cathedral, and that counselors of the old church reside in the high stratum of the cathedral ward.
Oh, really?
If you seek blood healing, and the church is willing, you should pay them a visit.
Visit their oodles of oodles.
Bergenworth is an old place of learning.
You mean it's
and
a
the
school?
Tomb of the gods, carved out below Yharnam, should be familiar to every hunter. Well, once a
somebody
group of young Bergenworth
like
scholars discovered
game.
A holy
like, yeah,
medium
over here.
Deep within the tomb. This led to the founding of the Healing Church and the establishment of blood healing.
Hey,
in this
we
sense,
start with, like, why
everything
it works?
Sacred in Yharnam can be traced back to Bergenworth. But today, the college lies deep within a tangled wood, abandoned and decrepit.
Like myself.
And furthermore, the Healing Church has declared Bergenworth forbidden ground. It's unclear how many of its scholars remain alive.
Not mine.
But only they know the password that allows passage through the gate.
Oh, good for them. Yeah.
I bid you farewell. It has been a pleasure. May the good
oodles?
Blood guide your way.
Oodles and oodles.
There must be oodles.
Oh, God, I was kind of hoping you would never
I
say that
I bid you farewell.
Again.
It has been a pleasure.
It has
May
been
the
a
good...
pleasure. I know. Just shut up. He's kind of rude, you know, walk away when he's talking. But, you know, it's a... It's like, how about we start with, like, why in this world... You know, it's never... I'm pretty sure that in real life, you know, if you, you know, if you're injured and somebody, you know, gives you their blood and you, well, drink it or ingest it in any way, you're probably just going to end up with AIDS or herpes or, you know, any number of bloodborne pathogens. Maybe that's what happened here? I mean, did we end up with a bunch of hepatitis? I mean, you know, makes sense, doesn't it? I mean, I mean, I know what they mean. That's just being an asshole in the game. This is a game. Oh, all right. Come on. Depth perception eludes me again. And you know, and I am too harsh, I think, on a lot of games, but... The thing is with this game, it's like it invites it. It's almost like it's not really being, you know, a bully if the person deserves it. This game is horribly hard. Obviously, I mean, if you've played any of the Souls games, the Dark Souls games, or anything, you're gonna be familiar with the mechanics of it. It's damn near a sequel as far as gameplay goes. I will never play a Dark Souls game because I already bought this one and I played it because I bought it, and it's not like I'm not gonna, I can't take it back because I got it as a digital download, so to hell with it. I'm gonna play through it and I'm gonna beat it, but I don't really need that torture again. I'll play something else that doesn't want to kick me in the balls every time I turn it on. It's... Although, for as much as people bitch about it, it's not as bad as, if you... Oh, goddamn it. If you play a sports game, like any of the... okay, I gotta get up there, that's the point. If you play like NHL 17, if you play that online, it can be ridiculously hard to win games online. You really have to pay attention, you have to practice, you have to know what you're doing, especially to get up higher, in the level. And that's probably about what this is. You can't just, sit here and pick your ass and play through Bloodborne like it's Super Mario World or something. Like, you're gonna pick it up and just, beat the crap out of it. But at the same time, it can be frustratingly hard, especially the way the game mechanics are. You die, and then you gotta go through a long section again. I hate that. It's like, don't punish me like that for being not very good at the game. I mean, it is what it is, I guess, but whatever, let's go through CSCS. Okay, so I got this. Okay, damn it, and there's this gate. I think I gotta get on this other side here, so I can't remember. I wouldn't be able to, go through that. Oh, of course not. I couldn't be able. I'm pretty sure I could actually climb over here if I needed to, but... I can't climb a small fence. Why would I be able to climb up there? That's not... So head down here by these assholes. This is a big fucking asshole here. It's the other way. Oh, no. Damn it. This part has always been a little confusing. There we are, I think. Yeah, I think we're right. Looks like I need to get down this area. It's funny, he's looking at it, the way I'm running here with this coat on. It's look like he's wearing a skirt. Oh, I'm sure he does. Where is he? Not over here. I do gotta give him props for the note system. That's awesome. I like the notes. They managed to put that in there without, Oh, now I'm gonna be right back up here with Alfred, ain't I? Oh, here we go. That's what I was looking for. There you go. Dead man's knowledge. The whole site with the whole insight system. It's I'll give him credit for that too. It's very, very original. It's kind of neat to the way it works, and as you go through the game, you realize that insight. Is it'll add things to the game there's details that you'll hear, you'll see in here. I'll try to play them as I go through the new game plus. It's, another one of these guys. I know. Make some beast, I know. I can't break those. Easy there. I'm trying to remember where I'm going. I almost never put my... Oh, hey, look at this guy. Hey now. Oh. Okay, I know where I am. Is this, high drop rate of upgrade materials for let's see. For your weapons, the and there's a lantern like right here. And in a certain extent, I've sat here and you can kill this guy over and over, go to the lantern, run back to where he is, and just kill him over and over and over again, and upgrade your weapons. It's a very easy, very, oh yeah. Circle. That was intelligent. Apparently, this is an old section of the town. Hey, what am I supposed to do? Boy. Come on, get down there. I'm gonna head back to the owner's dream.